Tepper, you played an integral part in establishing the Coburg City Superules Club, is that right?
Coburg, yes. We were first off called Reservoir Districts. That's, 22 years ago now. I started off, I played with another team, and then because I was living locally in Reservoir, I think we should get a Superules team, which we did. We got through it. We have changed a couple of times our name. Sorry, he started on the fair thing. But, we've changed our name. What I tried to do with the Reservoir District first off was have Reservoir, Lakeside, West Preston and ourselves as a unity. But unfortunately, West Preston and Reservoir don't like each other.
Ah, right, okay.
So we're a bit of a hatred. So we didn't get too many West Preston players. But over the years, we've had some and created history with ourselves. We've won two premierships with the Reservoir West Preston album under that identity in 99 and 2000, and under the Darabin one, which we then changed because of the local area, we won the 2009 premiership. So.
And you said 22 years ago were you playing?
Yes.
And when did you retire?
Last year.
Last year?
Last year.
Oh my God, how many games did you play?
Around about 230 Superules games.
Okay, right.
Overall about 780.
Okay.
Because I played with VFA and in Diamond Valley and all the way through.
Far out. So your desire to set up the Superules was to give something back to football?
Give something back because I knew the Superules concept. I felt it was a great concept. I was having 2 weeks between each game. What it's still done then is help the family situation, go to their family on the alternate week, still have a game of football, and those blokes who haven't played for 7, 8, 9 years were having a kick.
And
that rhythm. That gave them a 2 week recovery period as well.
Yeah, okay.
And they were able to do, as I said, the family thing as well. But then, as we got going, we created the family as a family. Great, and that's why we are now one family unit.
You have a look around the ground here, it's a massive family
unit. Yes, exactly right.
Yeah,
so and that's, as that type of club, we've created a family. I'm not saying other clubs are doing the same thing, but that's how we've tried to do it.
Here we are at Coburg City Oval. It's a far cry from the MCG, but what's your feelings right now as we build up?
Oh, look, I mean, it's just a great game, isn't it? And it's good watching these old boys run around, and Kane's a coach, so I come down here and give him a hand. Obviously, when the boys have a win, I'm the brains behind it. When they get beat, it's his responsibility.
So what about the butterflies? You still get that feeling of adrenaline and all that?
You know what? This is the thing. When you can't play, when your body's not good enough to stand up anymore, just the thrill I get out of watching the guys play, that's my motivation. Now.
And the knowledge that you can impart on these guys, do you want to take that further, or are you happy at this local level?
Look, I'm probably happy where I'm at the moment. I've got a young family and a busy working life as well, so I'm happy just putting it in a grassroots level and having some fun.
But that's what it's all about, isn't it? Giving it back.
It is, yeah, that's what it's all about. And look, especially, watching these guys play, they're all experienced campaigners, so they know what to do. But, I coach Northcote Park on a Saturday, and it's just good. I really enjoy watching the young guys come through.
Do they ever get to talk to you about anything else other than your career?
Oh, we talk about lots. I try not to talk about my career. It's done and dusted a long time ago.
Yeah, but these things, I mean, over 35s, over 47s, I mean, you're never too old to play, are you?
No, you're not. Look, and the guys play the game in great spirit as well. So whilst they, go in hard for the footy, they look after each other as well. And that's what it's all about, the spirit of the game.
And keeping fit, playing footy, the team camaraderie, it really is good for your mental health and your well-being.
It's a good lifestyle. The footy trips are still the same too.
Don't want to talk about that.
No, let it go.
All right, thanks a lot.
No problem, enjoy. Cheers.
Okay, so big news. You're captain today. That's because there's no one else playing, is that right?
Yeah, that's right, Matt. No, come up with a big job today, so hopefully we can go out with a win.
So this will be the first time you've ever been captain of anything in your entire life, is that right?
No, definitely not true, but definitely true for this club. I've only been in this club for, this is my second season, so it's a big day for me today.
No wonder you're nervous.
Yeah, typically, yeah, nervous for sure. Even though you're playing a lower side, you want to still have a good crack early and make sure that you put the goals on the board.
When did you find out you were going to be captain?
Last week, actually. Last week, and they expected text messages all week, so, we'll see what happens.
And you didn't let anyone know? You just kept that to yourself?
Yeah, the boys knew because they heard it said, but certainly, I've copped my fair share of... crap this week.
And so they reckon you're actually going to hit some targets today. Is that right?
Yeah, well, when the camera's on, hopefully I will. Yeah.
So what's the message you're going to be giving to the boys?
I think that we just need to use the ball well. I think we need to attack it well like we did in the last game. We played Williamstown the last game. They're second on the table. And I think if we use the ball well and we work together, I think we'll come out with a win.
Now, a little bit about the football that you're playing now. You're over 40. You're still playing footy.
Yeah.
What are the benefits?
I think it's the camaraderie and working with a club that, you know, you really find, you know, that come in together as a group and, you know, your social events and everything like that. So, you know, the club's very good culturally and I think that's a big bonus.
Is it any different? I mean, probably fitness-wise it would be, but any different the camaraderie from when you were playing when you were 20?
Yeah, it is. It is because, you know, you didn't know then what you know now and you just work together and, you know, everyone's there to play footy and have a good time and you need to help them out.
All right, no probs. Thanks.
Thanks.
Boys got a job too, Dave. Four guys. Macca's got kids' finals, Pizza Lego, Gambo and Gilly Wayne there. Boys. Fashionably late. All right, big day, last game of the year, but an important game for us. You know, we really want to finish the year on a high against, you know, probably, you know, because they're close and we play against them a lot, they're our biggest rival, I'd say, Plenty Valley. So, big challenge on our home ground. We want to finish well. We want to finish the year off and say, all right, we'll tick this one off, had a good win, finish the year off and look forward to next year. So today's very important. You know, we treat this game like our grand final today, all right? That's how we're going to line up. And as you can see, 24 players today, boys. So sort of a luxury we haven't had all year. So it's going to line up. Pete Saligo, Peter Cummings, Johnny, welcome back, Johnny. James, you can start half back. You were very good there last week, Jonesy.
So yeah,
Jonesy. Get over the footy, run off every time you got it. Bones, keep going, having a fantastic year. Gambo on half back. Gaz on the wing, Justin Lewis in the middle, and Dix on the other wing. Vess at half forward, welcome back to Big Eats. Yeah. I'll use your centre half forward, mate, and I'll give you a little bit of a run in the ruck, because I know you enjoy that too. So. And Zani, half forward. Play that fifth on baller role, mate. Did it brilliantly last week, so same thing. It's windy, same conditions as last game, so get down the backs, help them out, just be everywhere, bob up everywhere. Louis in the pocket, Mickey No, and of course our captain today is Hoochie, so.
Sneak in the back way.
Good reward for Hoochie, though, off. Been back at the club a year, but you know, the way you're passionate about it, and you know, that's what we want in this club. So, you know, he won't get behind you today. I'm sure he'll give, you know, 120% as he always does. So,
that'd be a shame.
That's supposed to be Carlo. My writing's been off today. Carlo, Gilly, and Macca. Gilly, swap with Hooch, okay, out of the pocket. And Louis and Tone Vest just at half forward. Louis, you just call that. Justin, where are you? Yep, you just call that. Keep it going, mate. You're having a great year, too. Cam Lovell on the bench. Good in your first game, Cam. That energy, that run you've got. Okay, we're going to use you through the wing again today. So, Dave, also we'll use you up forward. Lexi, Damo, welcome back to Damo. Also, welcome back to Marnes. And the big in, of course, is... Okay, before we look at the ground, it's boggy, okay, and slippery, so... Need to keep our feet. It's important today. As soon as you go to ground, yeah, the contests are no good. So we're 17 men. So must keep the feet today. All right, Plenty Valley. Okay, don't underestimate them. Good team. Still got some good players running around there. You know, for them to be second last, I think is not correct. You know, they're a better team than that. That's for sure. So they're not taking lightly. Don't think this is going to be a walk in the park. An easy win. They're going to be tough, especially early. All right, so forwards. Let's make sure we get in front. You know, at times we're going to have Mickey, we're going to have Eaton down there, and we're going to have Wiz. Three big guys, get in front. You know, that's why Mickey's been such a good player for so long. He gets in front, gets his big body in front. And in supers, we know you can't knee in the back. So let's make sure we get in front and we get our little blokes crumbing. All right, as I said, keep the feet and just keep moving around, okay? Okay, backmen don't like it when the forward, just keep running, you know, take them up the wing for a little visit up there. Just keep moving them around, okay? Right, backs were fantastic last week. Tight, first thing, let's be tight, man on. But run off. Bones, Pizza Lego, Gambo, run off when we've got it. Take that chance, we'll take them on again, all right? Especially when we've got the win, you know, take them on. Let's get it down there quick. All right, mids, okay, running hard. You know, with a bench, we can use is a lot of rotation. So expect this to be running as hard from the first bounce to the last bounce today, all right? And man up. Make sure when they've got the footy, you know, we yell out, we've all got a man, okay? I'm going to use the bench today. So, you know, everyone's probably going to come off. Just come off, might be for 5 minutes. Everyone's going to get a run. We're going to finish the game off. We're going to have a good win today, boys, all right? So, come on. Boys, final.
Ready, boys?
I'll say
good, mate.
Good,
buddy.
So Frank, what are your thoughts about this last game of the season? Big game for you guys?
Well, yeah, definitely. We've started off the year pretty slow. You know, we come close a few times, but you know, coming close isn't good enough. So we've been trying hard to win those games that have come fallen short at. We've been, you know, smashed with injury, and our team, the players that we've been playing with, we've been inconsistent for most of the year. So we look to fix that up. We won last week against Northern Districts. We don't want to read too much into that. They were on the man too. But today's a good opportunity for us to get a win. I'm sure that just deserves before a win as well. So I want to finish off the year well.
So you guys are, I think, second last. But apparently you've got a better list than that. You've got a better side than that. So it's just been one of those years, I guess.
It has. Yeah, it's been one of those years. But look, we're not finding excuses. We're accepting the fact that we've fallen under par a lot of the times, when we probably should have won those games. But we look to make amends today and start to work towards next year.
And what about the involvement in football still? I mean, you're not 20 years old anymore. So how important is it for you and the boys to maintain that involvement in a team sport?
Well,
I see that there's a lot of camaraderie and these hijinks are still carrying on like they would have.
Well, look, as I say to the guys, football's more than just football. There's the other 50% to it as well, and that obviously involves teammanship, you know, family and the social part as well. And if we can find that good balance, I guess you've got a successful team.
It's about grassroots footy, isn't it? It's about giving something back and just staying involved.
Yeah, exactly. Staying involved, trying to keep fit, trying to have some fun, and you know, building relationships and friendships.
All right, mate. Any last words?
No, that's all. Thanks for doing this today.
Yeah, no worries, Frank. Good luck and hope you do well.
Yeah, thank you. Cheers.
Monique, how are you involved in this footy league? What happened there?
Well, I was looking for a bit of work on the side, and because I'm an osteopathic student, and there was a lot advertised on the Facebook page, and then I saw it advertised with RMIT, so that's how I got involved. Yeah, just doing a bit of first aid and strapping and rubs.
And how do you feel about it? You like it? It's a lot of fun?
Yeah, I really enjoy it. Everyone's really kind, so it's a good place to work and, yeah.
And you're learning on the job, obviously, then?
Yeah, well, I've never worked with a football club before, so they've taught me most things, and yeah, so.
It's an education, I guess, being involved in a footy club. Is it something that you'll do next year as well?
Yeah, hopefully. Yeah, hopefully it'll help me with my course as well.
What's the worst injury you've seen this year?
I don't know, maybe a broken nose, concussion, that's about it.
Yeah, well, that sounds pretty good. That's a relatively minor injury in the big scheme of things. So,
yeah
so anything else that you'd like to add about the Super Rules?
Just that I really enjoyed my time working here, and hopefully I can come back next year.
All right, good on you. Thanks a lot. So you said before you played VFA. Did you actually play VFA football?
Yes, I played with Preston, under Alan Joyce, which was, I think, 67, 68, 9. And then I went over to Brunswick and I played with Keithy Gregg and Wayne Silverbush before they went to North Melbourne.
Wow, that would have been really interesting. So
really, really good. And then I was recruited by Keithy Burns. He was captain and coach of the Diamond Creek Football Club in the Diamond Valley. And then I went up there and played 350 Diamond Valley games between Diamond Creek for about 10 years and Reservoir for about 23, 4 years.
So football is really ingrained in your psyche, and it's a way of life.
I started playing football when I was about 8, 9 at the local North Reservoir, and I had a great ruckman who was Lenny Thompson.
Oh, right, okay.
Who went on to win a Brownlow medal, yeah. And he from Reservoir and a couple of other, few other players around, Barry Padley and a few others that I coached on the way through. I coached juniors as well when I was playing the VFA.
Yep.
And a lot of those juniors went on to VFL, VFA, and in between all that, I on the off-season, I coached athletics, which I coached Scudafides, Rocker, in the athletics. Then they were taken for football for $1,000
yep.
or whatever, and then you know what Coburg and Rocker done over their career. Yeah.
But that's what it's all about. I mean, if it's not for people like you, how does all that youth get nurtured and all that sort of thing?
Well, it never used to, but now, as I said, I'm not saying to pat myself on the back, but I think I've created a lot more atmosphere in relation to, as you say, 1,000 extra people to come down and want to play football again, or you know, and athletics.
And now you've got Jason Headley involved.
Jason's, yeah, he played a few games last year, but he's injured at the moment, and now he's coaching a Diamond Valley or a Northern Football League team,
yep.
Northcote Park. So but over all those, there's been a lot of XA, AFL, and yeah. all those players played.
All right, well, congratulations and enjoy the game.
Yeah, no, we will.
Now, I don't know anyone's numbers. 18. Carlo's just got the tap out.
It's Gary just got tackled.
Now the breeze is favouring right of screen, and this I expect will be the scoring end. So
Plenty Valley.
Yeah, big Brett.
And here's a shot on goal. It's out of bounds. So Danny Gambaro overran the footy. I think he's wearing number 26 by my team sheet. He is. If I get it wrong, I apologise. But the numbers are. Yeah, and some of the numbers are quite hard to pick up. So we're just going to have to wing this. It's a neat tap over the back there by Craig McKay. Good contest for the footy there. I think this is going to be a bounce. And the umpire's going to bounce
Louis,
the ball.
Louis, Macker and Jones in that.
So, guys, having the advantage of the win in the first quarter could prove crucial.
Correct.
Yep. I think in the over 47s game today, Coburg set it up early in that game using the wind. So, could be similar here today.
It's a beautiful day for football, though. But it is there is a slight breeze. Probably worth two or three goals. It's a flat throw-in. And the field umpire has asked
him
to be
thrown
back into play.
Johnny Mack for Plenty Valley in the ruck.
Carlo and Johnny Mack. It's a push out.
Carlo's free.
Free kick to Coburg City. He plays on to, that looks like it's Mark, what's his name?
And?
Yes, I know his name, Mark Gilman.
Yep, yeah, that's right.
Guy Gurney's got the footy out on the outer side of the ground.
To Jimmy Barnes.
And it's a neat pass.
To Priesty.
Already, there's a lot of loose men. As Tim Lane used to say, there's loose men everywhere. It's play on now. They should attack him.
Top of the square. Carlo's there.
Hands in the back. I thought I saw some hands in the back there, but it's play on. Ball comes
Bones.
Out.
Bones gets it out to Louis.
Louis's got it.
And Macker.
The wind holds that footy up out there on the wing. There goes Hooch.
That's Hooch.
He said he was going to hit some targets today because he's captain. He's got to set the example. That's a bad hand pass there by Peter Saligo and
left. Terrible kick.
Terrible kick.
Dane Bruni. Doesn't look like it, but
Dane Bruni.
Yeah. Plus
26.
Sorry, Danny Gambaro.
Danny Gambaro. Oh, he's kicked a goal. He's kicked a goal. No, he's touched. Touched. Should that have been a deliberate
well,
ball?
You
it should
just
be a free kick.
Think about it, wouldn't you?
Shades of Graham Allen at Western Oval in 1985.
Well, I thought that the 2008 Grand Final made sure that rule was changed, but anyway, they've got away with it.
Yeah, true.
And they come away courtesy of Mackay, and he's hand passed it out to Mark Gilman. Yep. Goes for a bit of a run. It's a neat little
That's
pass
the
there.
Zahn Yusinov.
Handball.
Here we go.
Kick across ground.
Yep.
Someone's got to get
Bones.
Into the footy. That's
Bones
a good dive.
Down there.
Come
on,
umpire. It's a bit high. And it's over the shoulder, and it's a free kick to
Bones.
Bones.
Danny Allen's his name, but
Danny Allen, we'll call him Bones for short.
He's gone to Lewis.
This one looks like
deliberate.
It's going to run out of bounds.
Deliberate.
And you could probably hear the exclamation from here.
Yes.
Sorry.
It was not a good kick. And
okay, Johnny Mack up in the ruck. Taps it down there to Volps. Balls to Joey Ahmed, the veteran. Joey does it, gives a don't ask. Smithy.
In the back. It's a very good Walshy. Tap on.
Walshy. Oh, Walshy, pick it up.
Oh. It's out of bounds. Out of bounds. Could have been deliberate there, but no.
Could have also been kicking danger, I thought.
The standard is pretty good. I know it's a bit windy, but as we'd expect, that a lot of the players down here and the breeze really needs to be taken advantage of here. Is he's a chance for a goal, and it's through.
Yep, Volps.
Volps.
Yep, Volps.
First score, second score on the board, 1-1-7 to nothing at the moment.
It's cracking day, isn't it?
It's a beautiful day for football.
Cracking day for football.
Probably about a 3 or 4 goal breeze down Plenty Valley's end.
Yeah.
At the present stage, I would say. So they're taking full advantage at the moment of it.
It's no doubt the wind is going to affect this game. Coburg City have not got the ball beyond the centre, but it's going to be hard to see how the run of the game will go until half-time.
Well, it's very blustery down there. It probably doesn't look it up here, but it really is swirling around down there anyway. But I noticed in the earlier game, Coburg kicked plenty of goals at both ends of the ground.
Okay.
Now, whether that was a reflection of the fact that they won the game handsomely or not, I don't know. But you can kick goals at the other end.
Goals at the other end are a premium at the moment.
And, yeah, and
Gilbert's
going
got it out
now.
Of the centre by the looks. Tony?
Just if they had a back pocket.
And here they go, inside it. 50 for the first time, and you can really see how that ball has been held up.
Oh, good desperation. Good desperation.
Comes out to...
Don't know who that was.
Don't know.
Yeah, Mackay. Mackay's got caught.
Oh, dropped it.
I thought it could have been holding the ball, but...
Yeah, they're letting it go a bit, aren't they?
They are, and it's the best way to umpire the game, that's especially right. On a day like today. Let them get the ball out and move it on. And we have another throw-in in the forward pocket for Coburg City.
Yeah, down at the chopper reed end of the ground.
Or the school end, as it's commonly known.
It's a pantry gen.
The pantry gen, right.
That's the reason why the chopper reeds.
Righto.
Inside
Benjich. And outside.
And outside.
Did he ever play for you guys?
No.
Didn't have enough tattoos.
Awaiting the kick here by Lewis.
Oh, no, it was Gambaro.
Gambaro, short pass. I thought that was a mark, but it's not.
Not playing with Mackay.
He's got to get the ball out, and the ball comes out.
Okay. Oh, here we go. Cleared from Plenty Valley. Kicks to the wing to where Walshy leads a race for the ball.
Oh. Once again, it's another throw, and I think we're going to see plenty of those today, guys.
Yeah, it's not a pretty game. Not a pretty game yet. I think that's indicative of the wind.
So we're playing like Ross Lyon coaches the Dockers in. Could be 5-4 or something.
It could be that type of game, couldn't it? Tell you what, though, Ross Lyon might coach him into a grand final, though.
Yeah, so. He might.
Yeah, but you got to also...
Here we go.
You got that's Ross Lyon, as you just mentioned. He's an ex-reservoir player.
Picks it up.
So
oh, do I?
He knows all about the wind factor out this
way. Zarnuzinov. Okay. Short pass.
Here it's on here.
Could have been a chance there. Oh, all he had to do is get up. Got the hand pass out. Here's a chance for a goal.
Mickey Noble.
Oh, it's
Noble.
A goal. It's a goal to Coburg City.
Carluch City is going to have him covered. Frank told me he had Mickey Noble covered today. I'm surprised that Mickey got away on him.
Maybe he bought a blanket for him. But that's a really crucial goal against the wind against a run of play. But it just shows that if you fight and scrap hard enough, you will kick goals to left of screen.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think that's what Coburg need to do for the rest of this quarter, just to hold it up and scrap it all the way to the forward line and see if they can choke the game just for this quarter.
They won't drop anyone, a loose man, in defence or anything at this stage?
No.
Sick to their structures?
I wouldn't think so.
It's funnily enough, we've done that against the breeze. We've got a loose man down there, Hammer. He's playing as a loose man across that half back line. And there goes Tony Mockbell with the ball.
Tony Mockbell.
Chip one over the top to Johnny
pass.
Mack. Oh, a bit of class. Johnny Mack turns, looks for
punch,
who
punch,
is that?
Punch.
Oh, it's a good punch.
Brett, probably held.
That's holding the man.
Go back and have a kick, Brett.
Now, can he kick the distance?
Yeah, he can go there. He can kick that. He can kick that easy, but he hasn't.
Chips it to the goal square. There's nobody there. And it's rushed through for a behind.
By Johnny Haddad.
So the scoreboard reads 1-6 to Coburg and 1-2, 8 points.
Yeah, Plenty Valley have done that.
I keep wanting to say Lower Plenty.
And Coburg.
Yep.
Coburg City.
Okay. So here we go. Tony Vesio or Vesio? It's a good pass.
That's Cameron.
Very good pass. Cameron's got the ball on the wing. Plays on with a short pass, but he's kicked to one on two. It wasn't a good kick, but the big fella there butters up, tries to get the footy out. He can't. It comes
Tony Mockbell's got it again.
Plenty Valley. Screw around the corner. Ooh, good contest. Go. Could have been a high tackle. But
Guy
no.
Gurney, long handball over to Benny Lakeland. Benny left footer over to Brett again, who I thought he should have kicked the last one. He won't kick that one. Goes into that pocket, which is going to be hard.
It's a good marking defence there. Looks
like the Plenty Valley forwards aren't actually reading the wind very well.
No. It's a good kick there. I think that was
you read it extremely well in the earlier game there.
He's played on. Could have been in the back.
Joey
Armand
gives it to Volps. Nice pick up. Class. Back to Joey. Joey goes short. Benny Lakeland. This bloke is a beautiful kick.
Fires at the goals, and it's just to the right-hand side.
And they could be wasting the breeze a little bit, just blazing away. Is it normally a good kick, Benny?
Yeah, one goal, what is it, 1-3. They could have easily been 3-1 with the shots that they've had. Waiting for the ball to come back into play. That was by Gambaro, was it?
Oh, he was off.
That's Damien Napolitano.
So is number 26 Danny Gambaro, or is he wearing a different jumper? So Zahn's got the ball deep in the back pocket while we try to figure out what the numbers are.
Kicking style, very funny action. He's kicking style.
26 is Gambaro. All right, okay. So he brings the ball across the face of goals, and it's a good pass.
Johnny had that. Tony
Vespia.
Oh, it's a very good mark.
Centre up the middle. Get it out to Peter.
Oh, he's picked out the opposition.
Oh, Frank Carlucci takes him on. Here he goes. Oh! Smother now over to Hammer. Boy. Hammer picks up the ball. Goes around onto his left. Looks for the hands.
Tony
no
Lucci
wrong way.
Has get it again.
No good. Goes and gets his ball again. Out there. Handball over to Priesty.
Big hole on the handball.
Yeah, go to Walshy. Walshy. Walshy needs to pick it up. Walshy gets it out again. Oh, Gary can't hold his feet.
Hooch is battling very hard.
Hooch ball up.
And
I think that's... I thought might have been in the back, but no, the umpire's going to throw this one up. Up it goes. Cameron in the ruck, no free kick paid. One thing I've noticed, Plenty Valley really are just tapping the ball on at every opportunity, tapping it forward.
Yeah, well, that's all you've got to do on a day like today. You just got to, that doesn't have to be pretty. You just got to paddle it forward, get it forward any way you can.
Ball comes back into play. It's a good throw. Rucks go at it.
Volps.
Comes out to Volps. He's tackled it. Good, dispossessed, but they don't seem to pay that anymore. There's Mark Gilman. He backs up. Good hand pass. Play on the wing. Gets another hand pass out.
To Napolitano.
Oh, could be a turnover. And this is where it kills you, especially with this wind. Dropped the mark. It's play on.
Coburg got a spearman here.
Got to get it out. That's a bit high, umpire. It's a free kick to Dwayne Bruni.
Yep.
Bruni to take the free kick. Centre half back.
Umpire could be easy.
Short pass, but geez, you can see how that the footy.
Out to Peter.
Saliga to Yuzanov.
Out to Zahn. Out to
Meschio.
Tony again.
Oh, blind Tony, beautiful.
Sending up the full forward.
And there's a man on his own, and he's going to kick a goal. He's go. Oh, I thought he was going to play on.
Tell you what, he might be worried out of this one. I don't think it's an easy kick for me.
Not with his wind.
No.
So, guys, who's actually got the football?
I think it's Cameron, isn't it? Little Cameron.
I don't know. It's going to be a very difficult kick from this pocket. It's almost a protected pocket, but it's right across the face.
Right across the face.
And it's out on the full. Maybe a banana would have been a better option there.
Yeah, possibly.
As we've been saying, it is a very, very tricky breeze here. You've played plenty of footy here, so what do you do on a day like today?
For this ground especially, get it on the swimming pool side, straight down the wing there. Don't go out too far because you get an extra kick out there. And the dead side's on that far side way over there.
Look like hands in the back there, but there's a contest here for the footy. Louis. Oh, good tackle, but is it? No, it's holding the ball. Holding the ball and advantage.